My background to tissue engineering in the field dates back approximately to 1996 when I was a surgical resident in the laboratory at the University of Pittsburgh, and basically serendipitously came upon some findings and observations in the lab that made us think there might be important cells in fat tissue, and fat tissue from under the skin as opposed to fat tissue that's found in the bone marrow. And we recognized early on that a major advantage of finding useful, medically useful cells in subcutaneous fat is that we can take more fat from someone as an outpatient surgical procedure than you can donate blood at the blood bank. Not only that, people are happy to give up their fat tissue, and there's basically no other human tissue like that, and so that makes it a very powerful, potential, translational and commercially viable source of bioactive cells and factors. And it ties in very nicely with what I do clinically as a reconstructive surgeon, because now we reconstruct certain defects or body parts by basically transplanting one part of a person's body to another part. Our lab has a couple different projects. On the one end, we have a clinical trial using fat-derived cells to regrow hair. And this is a phase one safety feasibility clinical trial. We recently completed a Department of Defense funded trial to evaluate fat grafting or fat transplantation and its ability to remodel scars and burn scars. It's become very apparent to me with Dr. March's arrival, especially, the timing right now at UF for regenerative medicine is really ripe. And what I mean by that is we've just now reached a critical mass, I think. So a critical mass of people interested in this field, a critical mass of diverse expertise and backgrounds so that we can tackle things like emphysema, treatment of osteoarthritis, muscle repair, hair growth, I mean, a wide range of clinical and scientific challenges. My hope and expectations for the Center of Regenerative Medicine are that Dr. March and the center are really going to lead the way toward team-based approaches to some of these very difficult challenges. It's certainly a time where one person in one lab can't solve these problems. And so a lot of the progress is being made by putting multiple different backgrounds, perspectives, expertise together.